So this is cylindrical obstacle experiment. The aim is to observe the pattern. So we will have a source, which is mostly a sodium source. And then it is placed in front of a, so in front you have a wire. So this is a wire, which is very tiny piece of wire. And actually what is done is, this piece is so small that it will not stand on its own, right? So what is done is, it is mounted in a metallic frame. And this frame is mounted on optical bench. So it has a stand kind of a thing, like this. So this is here. I will have a cylindrical wavefront here, which is going to reach at this cylindrical obstacle. According to geometric optics, if we go, we will say that, let me also increase this size of this circle. Why it is auto-correcting my diagram, I don't know. This is the top view of my wire. Now, when I'm joining it, it will form a range or the region of geometrical shadow on the screen. And this happens, you know, at a very large distance. Like the distance between this obstacle and my screen. So when I'm having this assembly, my screen is actually a telescope. Because, you know, in laser you use screen because you cannot observe laser. But when you are using sources other than that, then instead of screen, we have a micro telescope using which we can observe the pattern. And that is a thing which is mounted and which is going back and forth. So we will have a telescope here, and whatever I want to see in this range will be focused using a telescope, and that telescope will be moving here and here. So it is the top view of the optical bench. So it will be moving right and left that way. This will be the geometrical shadow region. And this will be illuminated. But now we have studied about diffraction at straight edge. So that edge you are going to see on the edge of the wire, right? So you will have straight edge diffraction happening here and here. Am I right? So where straight edge diffraction pattern will be formed? Here and here. Agree? This is wire, right? So it is, can you say that this wire is nothing but combination of two straight edge with an opaque place in between?
Yes, ma'am.
So edges of the wire will serve as straight edge. Not straight, but curved edge rather, we should say. So the edges of the wire will curve, will serve as curved edges, along with straight edge diffraction will happen. And you know what happens in straight edge. In the geometrical shadow region, you will have exponential decay of intensity. And in the illuminated portion, you get the fringes. So where is shadow region? Inside. And where is illuminated region? Outside. So now you will have the pattern which will be formed. Now this time it will be opposite. Like this. And this side it will be like this. What will happen in between? This is a very exaggerated diagram that I have drawn because I wanted to show the difference between the edge diffraction and what is happening in the center. Now let us look at what will happen in the center. In the center, we will have diffraction happening, which will turn our wavefront like this, and from this end like this. In between region, which is here, this will be the source of interference pattern. So here, I am having interference pattern because of two sources. One source is here, one source is here. So the requirement for interference to happen is you should have two coherent sources. So these two curved wavefronts are now my two coherent sources, which are going to interfere in this zone. That's why here I am going to get interference bands. these interference bands are little uneven, not that uniform thickness. So you have to figure it out and tell me why. The width of these and the number of fringes that come in the shadow region will depend upon the diameter of my cylindrical obstacle. If my diameter is very thick, I will get larger number of these bands. If it is really thin, then even it might happen that it will so happen that you will not get anything. So there is a critical width for which you will get these bands. So as you start to increase the width of the cylindrical obstacle, till some time you get those increase in number of bands, but the width should not be so large that it will go beyond the coherence. The property of coherence should be maintained to the two sources which are created, one above and one below. So how we calculate fringe width for this central portion, can you guess? We will apply interference or diffraction. So this experiment is done by keeping telescope here. So what you want to measure is your diameter of wire. You know the wavelength of light, and hence when your telescope is in this region, you measure fringe width. So we know our equation for fringe width, which is given by beta equal to d lambda by d. Why it is auto-correcting? Sorry, 1 minute. D lambda by d. Interference, this small d is the distance between the two slits. So now we can say that these are my two sources basically. So I have one source over here and one source over here. And these are separated by this distance. So this is my small d. This is small d and this is capital D. So small d is diameter of wire, capital D is distance between obstacle and the screen, or in experimental case, distance between obstacle and the place where your telescope is mounted, and it's a monochromatic light where lambda is wavelength. Okay, so using this equation, so what is done is experiment is actually you measure these position of minimas. So when we do this experiment in lab, generally we get 6 minimas. Like here I have showed only 4. So you can measure the location of 1, 2, 3, and 4 and use the half table method to get this fringe width. So once you know this average fringe width, from there you can get to know the diameter of the wire. This is this cylindrical obstacle experiment. A very narrow vertical slit illuminated with sodium light of wavelength 5.9 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. So it's given. Casts a shadow of vertical copper wire 1 mm in diameter and 2 meters away. So this 2 meter away is from the source to the wire on a screen 3 meters away from the wire. Calculate the distance apart of the bands inside the shadow and the total number of bands which can be seen. So the bands inside which we are talking about here is the interference bands that you are going to see. Second question asks the number of bands that can be seen. So let us first draw a diagram for it. So for the diagram, we have the source. Also, in that cylindrical obstacle experiment that we discussed, one more thing is important. We also keep first a slit in front of a source. So let's say you have a source, then this source, which is spherical, is actually converted into a cylindrical source by putting a slit in front of it. And then that slit becomes a source of cylindrical wavefront. And then you put your wire in front. You don't put directly a wire in front of a spherical source. Okay, so you have a source. So now when I draw this kind of diagram, it is for both. So this diagram, as you see here, it's a 2D diagram. So spherical also is shown like this only, cylindrical also is shown like this. But because it's a top view, it is going to be in the same curve downward. Like, you know, how you have paper which is curved. But if it's a spherical, then this will be a part of a sphere. So here it is cylindrical, okay? Don't confuse it with this. So first, a source which is spherical is passed through a narrow slit, which converts spherical into cylindrical. And then it is going to hit our wire, which is kept over here. So this is our wire. We are given wire diameter. So wire diameter is, how much it is? 1 mm. Then next quantity that we are given is the two distances. So we have, so let's say I have a screen over here. Let's call screen AB. Then we are given two distances. First is this, which is saying 2 meters away on the screen, 3 meters from the wire. So this is our wire. So I have this distance as 2 meter and this distance as 3 meter. So basically this is our A and B. So given your, always write first what is given. You know, it makes our life easier. So you have, wire diameter 1 mm. Then you have given lambda equal to 5.9 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. Convert everything into, you know, meter. So write this also as 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Lambda as 5.9 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Your A is 2 meter and B is 3 meters. So now, the first thing that we can calculate is the fringe width. So you will have, so you are going to get basically two things here. One will be this wavefront when it will reach here. We get our interference fringes in the geometrical shadow region. Am I right? This zone, which was otherwise dark. Shadow region, which has, which will be having interference fringes now. Now we are ignoring that right hand and left hand side part of straight edge. Now we want to see how many number of such bands are going to appear. So the number of band is actually controlled by the area of geometric shadow of the wire. Okay, so we are going to make use of that as well. So let us do it. So let us first calculate the fringe width. So now we have beta equal to d lambda by d. And our d is 3 meters. We are not going to take 5 because here this d is only related to the distance of screen from the obstacle, which is wire. So 3 into 5.9 into 10 to the power minus 7. Divided by, we will take the whole diameter, which is 10 to the power minus 3. Answer is 0.177 centimeter. Now we need to look at the geometry. So let's see here. So because here are my sources, right? New sources created. So I have one source here, S1 and S2. So these two are our two sources which are going to interfere with each other to give these fringes. Now I have this S1. So you have S1, S, S1, S2. And other triangle is S, A and B. Can I say these two are similar triangles? Yes, I am going to make a line here. So one triangle is this. Okay, and another triangle is this. So from the property of similar triangles, we can take, no, I mean, if these two are similar triangles, what we are interested in this part, right? AB to SC and S1, S2 to SO, which we have AB upon SC would be equal to S1, S2 upon SO. So how much is AB that we need to know? So AB would be S1, S2 into SC upon SO. So our S1, S2 is the diameter, which is 10 to the power minus 3 multiplied to SC is what? SC is the total distance. Now you will use 5 meters divided by SO is 2. So how much this is coming? 0.25 centimeters. How many fringes can accommodate in 0.25? You are given one fringe width, that is from here to here is only how much? 0.177 centimeters. So we got one value. So let's say these are my bands. From the geometric shadow, we got to know that this geometric shadow is coming somewhere like this. This is my wire. Okay. So for this wire, here I have, so how much this value you got? 0.25 centimeters. And one fringe width is coming out to be 0.177 centimeters. So this one end to end will only be 0.177. So how much is the rest of the value? So if I subtract the two, 0.250 minus 177, how much it will be? 7 and 0, right? So this 0.73 centimeters is left on right end. So the extra space, you again divide that by 2 because it will be half. So you will have 0.036 centimeters of space on each side of this right part. So you will have this band is how much? This band is 0.177. Then after this band, this and this, how much light part is left is actually 0.036 on each side. So how it will appear on screen would be, a better version of it would be like this. So I will have one bright. So this is my central bright. And then let's say this is the dark. And then you have again bright. So only this much part is cut now. Only this much is visible because this is that geometric shadow. In your answer, what you will write? Two dark bands will be observed.